Buongiorno. In questi temi così tecnici mi dispiace, ma non potrò parlare in italiano. L'organizzazione del seminario mi ha chiesto un testo in inglese e la sumula di questo testo che vado a presentare adesso. I'd like to start thanking the organization of this event for inviting me. It's my pleasure to share with such distinguished specialists in these fields some information about the subject of this seminar on which concerns my country, Portugal. As it happens everywhere else, we also try in Portugal to assist to the specific problems of the metropolitan areas and which concerns the need to coordinate public policies on zoning, territorial planning, habiting, public transportation, etc., to better serve the inhabitants on these areas. At the administrative organizational level, we try to answer these problems associating municipalities. Municipalities are what in Italy you call comune, municipio in Portugal. Each one of them don't lose her individuality, but they associate to work together to solve their common problems. We didn't create new administrative bodies directly elected by the people to rule metropolitan areas, exercising some of the powers that belong to the municipalities. But the law just predicts the association of municipalities. The public officers of these associations, that we call metropolitan areas, are not directly elected by the inhabitants of the metropolitan area. They represent the municipalities that belong to the association. At executive level, they are in fact altogether the mayors of these municipalities who integrate the board of administration that rules the association. Here in Italy, that's the sindico. You can imagine this doesn't work very well because each mayor is more interested on pursuing the purposes of his municipality than the general interests of the metropolitan area. And this is the cause of some problems on the effective activity of this board of administration. At this point of my presentation, I would like to inform you that regional and local administration are controversial subjects at the moment in Portugal. In fact, we have two political regions in the islands, in Açores and Madeira. They have a special statute, like I believe it also happens here in Italy with Sicily and Sardinia, but in which concerns the rest of the territory, we don't have a regional administrative structure. We only have the municípios, the comune. That's like if, for instance, here in Rome, you didn't have the Lazio region, but only the municipality of Rome and other towns around. Some people have struggled during the last 20 years in Portugal in order to introduce a regional level of administration that would perform an intermediary role between the state at the national level and the municipalities. This is important to understand the point we have reached at this precise moment in Portugal, on which concerns administrative organization at the inferior level as the national level of the state. And this is important because some years ago, a government that presently is not longer in office tried to promote the creation of so-called metropolitan areas in order to replace the institution all over the country of a regional level of administrative organization. In fact, we only have in Portugal actually two areas that have a real metropolitan dimension. That is at Lisbon, which is the seat of government, and in Oporto. And that's why, since 1991, the law imposed both in Lisbon and in Oporto the existence of two metropolitan areas, directly defining which municipalities belong to each of these metropolitan areas. So their existence is legally binded. They are associations of municipalities, as I have already told you, but their existence is imposed by law to the municipalities that are legally obliged to belong to them. But in 2003, a new law came to allow all the municipalities in the country to associate themselves in new so-called metropolitan areas in order to pursue together their common needs. This law, from 2003, predicts two kinds of metropolitan areas. What it calls big metropolitan areas that must have at least 350,000 inhabitants and urban communities that must have at least 150,000 inhabitants. The municipalities are free to decide if they create or not and belong or not to one of those associations. And we have now in Portugal several of these new kind of associations. But recently, the government that is in office decided to extinguish these so-called metropolitan areas because it wants to promote the creation of a regional administrative level of organization, provided of directly elected bodies, that very imperfectly these strange kinds of so-called metropolitan areas were intended to try to replace. So I believe we shortly will have again only in Portugal two metropolitan areas in Lisbon and Oporto. In 2008, a new law was made to rule these two metropolitan areas of Lisbon and Oporto. As I have already said, they are associations of municipalities that work with the mayors and other representatives of those municipalities that are indirectly elected. They are elected by the bodies of the municipalities to represent them at the metropolitan area. Trying to be brief, I must add that the powers the law gives to these bodies of the metropolitan areas of Lisbon and Oporto are not very strong. The law recognizes them the right to participate at the rule-making procedures on public investment and strategic, economical, social, and environmental planning on which concerns the metropolitan area. But it doesn't recognize them any impeachment power on which concerns the national policies on those matters. The planning is made by the state, and the metropolitan areas have only the right to participate on this procedure. So they are mainly called to coordinate local policies between the municipalities that are involved or with the state agencies and utilities on such matters as water and energy supply, health equipments, natural resources, garbage, public security and public transportation. The law also admits that some municipal powers, like the power to give some licenses for private activities, may be transferred by the law from the municipalities to the metropolitan areas, and also allows the municipalities to transfer directly some of their tasks to the metropolitan areas. This goes in the sense of increasing the role of these bodies in the structure of local administrative organization in Portugal. The metropolitan areas may also sign contracts with the state in order to assume some of the